My name is Chris Owen. I'm the deputy head and year 4-5 teacher of Deighton Primary School. One of our aims is to provide the children with the best possible experiences we possibly can. The brilliance of the Welsh Valleys engineering project is that we were providing experiences that we may not necessarily have been able to do within our normal school day. We teamed up with Talis and NDEC. We had sort of three main aims with regards to the project. Number one was to raise aspirations of the children, make them aware of the jobs that were available within the engineering sector for when they were older. Our second sort of goal was to try and encourage the children to develop that sort of message of internet safety. Our project was cyber forensics and digital forensics, so we wanted to really make sure that that message for internet safety was spread throughout the both classes that took part. And the third then was probably the most challenging. We wanted to make sure that we had activities that we could embed for the future. We didn't want the project just to be a one-off. We wanted to make sure there were things that were embedded for children who were going to move classes and future classes to take part in.
I'm Holly Lidbury. I work at the National Digital Exploitation Centre, or NDEC for short. We wanted to engage with the Welsh Valleys Engineering Project because we have very similar objectives. One being that we're focused around the South Wales Valleys area. Our project over the 8 weeks, we sort of set up this story where the Jaguar I-Pace that we have had been stolen. And we tried to make this as real as possible. You know, we came in on the day, the Jaguar was in the schoolyard. We had hazmat suits, evidence logs, and we'd planted all this evidence within the car and said to them, you know, the Jaguar's been stolen from the NDEC. Since you've been learning about cybercrime and digital forensics, we thought we could ask for your help. And we tried to set it up like it would be in real life. They went in groups, they collected the evidence, they had to, you know, bag the evidence up securely, write notes.
I like going into the Jaguar so then we could get the evidence. I also was the person who did the bagging and tagging. So that somebody would go in the car, get the evidence, you would put it in the bag, then you tag it, then you go give it to the other person to mark it all down in your notebooks, and that's all the steps done and that's your evidence. Now I feel like I know a lot about cybersecurity.
So this morning we had to get into groups and then it was my turn to go up to the judge, and I tried to give all my evidence and I said everything I could have. The judge said, like, do you have any evidence? And I said, yeah, and then passed him the bag. And I asked about the money to show that I had £850 in the bag, and I gave it to them then. We thought Miss Johnson and Mr. Owen did, and we was right. We all knew that from the start. At the end, we found out that it was Mr. Owen and Miss Johnson. And then they got arrested by Mr. Waith and got tucked into Mr. Waith's office.
What was great was just the surprise that we had, basically, that some of the children who might not necessarily engage in your usual literacy, maths or topic work really got stuck in with some of the activities, things like hacking, things like coding.
I think that the Welsh Valleys Engineering Project has completely expanded what we did before. I think we've really seen the value of both long-term engagement and engagement with younger pupils. Through this, we've created two long-term projects that we can replicate with other schools. So it's given us the vehicle to have further engagement with more schools, reach more pupils. And we're intending to sustain this engagement with the project